Again, welcome everybody from Taze Valley Baptist Church. Thank you all for coming. Looking forward to the combined choir here this evening. My, what a blessing that's going to be.
And what made my life new? It was the story so old.
Yeah. Oh no, the old story will never grow old. How Jesus died to save my soul. Oh no, the old story will never grow old. That story will never grow old. Anybody here who knows he's able?
Yeah.
If there's anybody here who's seen his power, anybody here walk through the fire,
Lord, what a blessing it's been to be here tonight. You know, I thought, man, to just have the opportunity to be in service like this, you know, in times of need, it's great to have friends. And, Pastor Smith is my best friend. And, we talk a lot and try to encourage one another. He's always an encouragement to me. The church is always an encouragement to me. And I just want to say thank you to Taze Valley Baptist Church for being here for this special time. I know you all had your service and then came up. And so I'm going to ask Pastor Smith if he can come.
Thank you, Brother Lee. Good to see all of y'all. On Friday night after the waters came in, I prayed all night for you folks at Mount Pleasant. I prayed for your pastor's safe return. And I asked the Lord that night what he would have us to do as a church to help him. I came up and I saw your preacher. Now, Pastor, I'm going to say this to you. He's in blue jeans. He looked like he's 100 years old. Now, listen to me. I could tell the hurt, the disappointment, the pain, not just for the loss of the church, but for all his people's loss. I just appreciate you for standing strong.
Yeah.
That morning, God laid a finger on my heart. I told Lee, and Lee, his faith was small. No, he, you know, God just laid the finger in my heart. These men up here by my side, our deacons, this Brother Jared's on our staff. We had a staff meeting, a deacon meeting the next Sunday morning after this. I told him what God laid on my heart, and that was to give you, our church, give you $100,000.
Yeah.
And I didn't know how they react, but these men love God.
Yeah.
And they responded. Our church has to go through a procedure. We announced it three times for over a week. When we had the vote, it was a 100% vote.
Yeah.
Not one person.
Yeah.
Not one person. and Leah, they should, there's two checks in there, right? The influence of our church, I was on YouTube with Brother Lee, mentioned it, and a church in Kentucky that knows me sent $1,200 and added it to the $100,000. So Lee, on behalf of Taze Valley Baptist Church, these deacons, my staff, it is an honor to give you a check from our church for $100,000 and a church in Kentucky for $1,200. God bless you.
What do you say? Thank the Lord. Thank you all. Brother Smith, when you first mentioned doing something for us, you didn't mention any figures, and I thought Brother Smith and the church, they may give us $10,000 to help us out in this. I had no idea until you later told me what y'all were thinking about doing. And honestly, when I got back from Wyoming, and you saw me just shortly after I saw for the first time. We got home at 12:30 Friday night, and power was off, there was mud everywhere, police were out front. I just, you know, didn't even want to go on the lot at the time of night. And honestly, my heart was sunk. I thought, first, how will we ever get this mess cleaned up? I mean, I thought, how will we ever get this mess cleaned up? And second, how will we ever rebuild this church? And you know, for the first week, and I told the people here, you know, we go home and everybody here worked such long hours, and you know, there was just so many people coming by to encourage. That first week, it was hard to even get to the bathroom or be able to eat anything because of so many people coming by to encourage. And the Lord just gave me peace. The first three or four nights, I'd go to sleep right off the bat because I'd be so tired, but I'd wake up at 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock in the morning, and all this stuff would just start on my mind. You know what that's like as a preacher? You know, how are we ever going to do this? You know, we just borrowed all this money to finish school. Can't borrow any more money. And it's just like the Lord told me, be confident in this very thing, Philippians 1:6, that he that hath begun a good work in you will perform it to the day. And it's like the Lord, I didn't hear a voice, but it's just like he reminded me that I didn't start this church, he did. And I haven't sustained this church all along, and he did. And that the same God that started this church and sustained this church and this school all these years, it's the same God that's going to keep it going until the day of Jesus Christ. And it just like the burden was lifted off of me. I'm not saying the devil doesn't jump up here every now and then and get a word or two in. You know how that goes. But I just, this is one of the greatest services, one of the greatest things that I have ever experienced. And I know that you all as a church will be able to look back on this night and realize what an act of sacrifice and love that you all have bestowed upon us, and we just cannot thank you enough. And
I want to speak tonight on this subject, a journey of trust. When we come to this passage of Scripture, you are familiar with it, I'm familiar with it. I have found out something in studying the life of Ruth, that faith and trust is a journey.
Amen.
Faith just doesn't start when you get saved. Doesn't end when you get saved. I tell you, when faith ends, it ends when you die.
Amen. Yeah. Yeah.
Let's be honest about tonight. We're going through a process. Hey, this church, you're going through a process. You're going through a journey.
Yeah.
And that journey is a journey of faith. I do know this. When Ruth said to Naomi, whether thou goest, I will go.
Yes.
And whether thou lodgest, I will lodge. Thy people will be my people. And thy God, my God. I'll tell you this, she got in touch with God. The first thing that happens when you get into this journey of faith, you trust Jesus Christ as Savior.
Yes.
A lot went on tonight about helping this church and helping them financially and help them to get this building built. But I want to tell you what tonight is. If you're here lost, it can be a start on a journey. Amen. The greatest journey of your life. If you get saved tonight by the grace of God.
Yes.
Amen. Well, that Saturday morning, I saw some of you people. Man, they were working hard. One particular man, I can't think of who he was, walked out of all that mud and tears running down his face. He said, all our dreams are gone. He said, I know there ain't a pew in there. I want you to know something. I don't understand this, but I want you to know something. In this journey, there are going to be some disappointment.
Yeah.
And I want you to know that disappointment is not to break you. It's not to ruin you.
Amen.
That disappointment is to help you.
Yeah.
I don't understand everything I'm about ready to say, but I want to say something to Mount Pleasant Baptist Church. God Almighty has allowed this problem.
Amen.
I don't understand it, Brother Lee. He's not mad at you. He's not upset at y'all. But here's what I believe. I believe God has allowed you to go through some disappointment right now. And I want you to know the end's coming.
Amen.
They haven't thrown all the story yet.
Amen.
They haven't told it all yet.
Yeah.
The end's coming. God's got some grace for you.
Yeah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Well, hallelujah. Ladies and gentlemen, in this journey, we're going to come to places that I'm sure Mount Pleasant, you have felt it, Pastor. I know you have felt it. I even felt it, that this was so much despair. This was out of measure. This is more than anybody should take. But I am glad. Thank God that I can put my trust
yes.
in God that said, I'll never leave you.
Yes.
I'll take you. You can go all the way with you.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord.
Yes.
Our trouble is a happenstance only seen by us. But God saw me. God saw Ruth.
Yeah.
He saw the end of the story.
Yeah.
He saw what he was going to do for that young man. Somebody say amen.
Yeah.
Hey, some of y'all going through some trouble tonight. Hey, I know this church has been through it, but you got several members that's been through it, haven't you, Brother Lee? Can I tell you something? I got a God. If you'll trust him tonight, he's already seen the end. He already knows what he's going to do. He knows he's going to bless you. Somebody help me. I feel real good right now.
Yeah.
I want you to know, Ruth said, I came to trust. You said, am I ever going to get through? Is God going to bless me? I tell you what he did. He gave her great-great-grandson the victory in the Valley of Ben and cut the head off of life and got the victory of Mount Pleasant. You're going to get the victory. Somebody help.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Good preaching.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
And I want to say something to my church. Tate Valley Baptist, because of your trust, and you didn't let it, you wasn't worried about $100,000, you just believed God,
amen.
God's going to give you a full reward too.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
He's going to bless your youngins. He's going to bless your wife. He's going to help you through.
Amen.
You can count on it.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
I'm done, but I'm going to give you this. If you're here tonight and you've never been saved, you need to trust God tonight.
Yeah.
You need to get saved tonight. And if you're here tonight and you're a Christian, you say, preacher, I'm battling defeat. I'm battling disappointment. But I am willing to trust. Why don't you come up and continue a journey of trust tonight? Oh, some of you have been beat up real hard the last few months. But God said you can trust him.
Just thank the Lord for what God has done here this evening, the joy of just being together with Taze Valley and the blessing of worshiping together and then the blessing of the tremendous gift and the message, Brother Smith, that was tremendous. And
yes,
thank you so much for encouraging us and thank you for the encouragement that you've been to me. And praise the Lord, we're all in this together. And aren't you thankful that one day God's going to call time and say, you've had enough. We're going to go home and we're going to be with him.